If you've reached question 21 on the assignment booklet and you're having trouble with it, this might be a good question to look at as an example of how to approach question 21. Question 21 in assignment booklet D1 talks about calculating the amount of chemical energy that's released in a combustion reaction. Now the compound it's talking about is methanol, which is CH3OH. I'm going to use a different compound, but all of the processes that we're going to talk about in this example will be paralleled exactly in question 21 in D1. So, to begin with, the question says, butane, the compound C4H10, is the fuel that's used in lighters. When released from the lighter, butane turns into a gas and it burns in the air. So we have two things that we're asked to do. One, get a balanced equation for the complete combustion of butane. And then we're asked to determine the energy change per mole of butane as it burns. And it implies that we're going to have to use the equation to do that. So we've got to do one before we can get to two. The important concepts here are the fuel, butane, which is a hydrocarbon, and the fact that it's undergoing complete combustion. So what does that really mean? It means this, that our hydrocarbon, C4H10 gas, is going to burn, which means we're going to add oxygen, and since it's complete combustion, the products are going to be CO2 gas and H2O gas. The definition of complete combustion is to burn in the air to produce only carbon dioxide and water. At this point, we need to balance the equation. So a good way to balance is to balance carbons, then hydrogens, and then balance the oxygens at the end. So I'll begin. I have 4 carbons in butane. So that means I would need 4 CO2s to provide me with the 4 carbons. I then have 10 hydrogens in butane. So to get 10 hydrogens, I'd have to put a 5 in front of the H2O. 5 times 2 is 10 hydrogens. Now, I've generated a lot of oxygen as a result of balancing the carbons and hydrogens. So I'm going to add them up, and then I'm going to go back to the O2 molecule and see how many of them I need to balance it. So 2 times 4 is 8 oxygens in the CO2, plus another 5 from the water is 13 oxygens. That's an odd number. I already start getting a feeling that this might be difficult to balance. So I have O2 molecules as the other reactant in this reaction. I can't take a whole number of O2 molecules and get 13 oxygens to balance. So that means that I can do one of two things. I can balance with a decimal or a fraction, or I can double the amount of product butane and then rebalance. And that's going to be my approach. So when you run into a problem where you can't balance the oxygen molecules with a whole number, go back and double the starting material. So that means I'm going to backtrack my balancing here, and I'm going to double the amount of butane. So now that gives me 8 carbons, so that means I'm going to have to take 8 CO2s. That gives me 20 hydrogens, 2 times 10, so that means I'm going to have to take 10 water molecules. Now I'll deal with the oxygens, add up how many I've got, 16 in the CO2, plus 10 times 1 is another 10 in the water, so that's a total of 26 oxygens, and now I can balance that off easily. 26 oxygens is going to be 13 O2 molecules. So now this equation is balanced. Now, let's go on to part 2.